Who wants pizza? Everybody wants pizza. Who knows how to make pizza? Not too many people. But it's very simple. That's what I'm going to show you. I've done this before, but this is my classic South Jersey boardwalk pizza. Now, some people might balk at some of the ingredients because they figure you got to use mozzarella. I don't use mozzarella when I make this particular pizza. By the way, I don't know what mozzarella is. If you mean mozzarella, that's what they say when you're in Rome. But since we're here in America, I say mozzarella. That's what the American pronunciation is. If you say mozzarella in Rome, they'll think you fell off a garlic truck and hit your head. Anyway, we're using mild cheddar or Monterey Jack today with this. Now, there's a famous place on the boardwalk in Ocean City that has pizza places on either side of it that are not empty, but not as busy as this place. It begins with an M, and it also has another M. You know the place. Delicious. I got the secret to their pizza. My family loves it. Anybody I give it to loves it. I took a woman from Sicily there once. She's so critical, as most Italians from Italy are, about everything. She even said, oh, questo buono, this is good. She's so critical, she would tell the Pope his beanie is on wrong. So even she liked it. And I'm sure you'll like it. Now, back in the old days, to make pizza at home, you'd have to get a stone. Oh, I got a stone. You put it in the oven. It gets to be 1,000 degrees. You can't move it. And since you can't make it on there, you had to buy the paddle, right, to put it on there. And a friend told me, my wife used a screen. I said, a screen? What do you mean a screen? Like the screen door screen? He said, no, it's a special screen. You make a pizza. I said, that can't be right. It's a screen. That's stupid. For years, I resisted. Finally, I went out and bought a screen. These things are amazing. Because the heat gets through it, the air gets through it, whatever happens, it's terrific. A couple of dollars at one of those fancy kitchen stores, William Sonoma, Tommy Sonoma, Sirla Tabu. A lot of people don't go into that store because they don't know how to pronounce it. Sirla Tabu. Anyway, here's the screen. You get it at a kitchen store. Now the pizza dough, a lot of supermarkets sell the frozen pizza dough, it's fine. If you don't have the time to let it thaw like today, then I'm gonna go to the pizza shop up the corner. We're in Jersey. Every corner has a pizza place, or every little shopping center has a pizza place where two little guys from Italy came over, opened the pizza store, hired three little Mexicans to bake it, and that's where you get a pizza dough. So I went to them, I said, hey, got a thing of dough? Well, you don't like my pizza? I said, no, it's for my mom. If you tell them it's for your mom, then they'll go, oh, okay, $4. And I think this is like two or three in the supermarket. So since I didn't have time for it to thaw, we went to Pizza Parlor pizza dough. This might come out a little bigger than I want. Now, you don't want to throw it around, right? Because you don't know what you're doing. I don't know what I'm doing when it comes to making pizza and twirling it. You got to school in like Milan for like 5 years to throw that thing the right way. So what I do is smack it. You watch the guys in the pizza shop, right? They smack it around, cover it with flour on top of your countertop. Now, if I start twirling this around, I have flour all over the walls. I don't want to do that. Who wants to do that? So, sin of all sins, I am using the rolling pin. Oh, yeah, but then you take the air out and I don't know what it does to it, but it makes it thin, flat, and crispy. That's what I want, a thin, flat, crispy pizza. Okay, so you roll it. You want to make sure you keep it round. So you keep on this side, that side. And you roll it out, right? Now comes the tricky part, because you got to get this thing that you've rolled out nice and flat and round, and you kind of eyeball it to see, am I getting it the size of my screen? All right, so that looks about right. And it's going to stretch as you move it a little bit, okay? So how do I get this onto the screen? Well, I fold it over once, right? Put it on the screen, move over the flour, and then I unfold it on the screen. Look at that. Beautiful. Perfect. Nice and thin. I didn't have to twirl it, make a mess. And I'm going to put it on. I didn't have to worry about the paddle and the stone, which gets to be hotter than you know what. And I got to move it with the stone still in there. The screen. $10? I don't know what it is at one of those fancy kitchen stores. This is salt, pepper, garlic. Do, 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 on the dough. Right on the dough. Do you do it on the dough? Do it on the dough. Now, I told you earlier, we're not going to use mozzarella. We're going to use mild cheddar. Yes, or Monterey Jack. Here we go. Cheese first? What are you, crazy? What's wrong with you? This is the way they make it on the boardwalk in Ocean City at that place that begins with M and the other name begins with M. You know what I'm talking about. People line up for miles. My Sicilian friend said, oh, chi sta buono. And she doesn't like anything. Okay. So here we go. This is tomato sauce, pizza sauce from Williamstown, New Jersey, Don Pepino's. Best pizza sauce in a can I've ever tried. Yeah, you can make your own. It's simple. Get some tomatoes, crush them by hand, put a little basil, blah, blah, blah. This already made for you. Sweet, delicious. I cut it with a little olive oil and a little bit of water. Why? Because I feel like it. It's a little thick when it comes out of the can. So here we go. We're pouring the sauce on top of the cheese, on top of our pizza. It's going to spread as it cooks. I have the oven set for 500 degrees. 500 degrees. You're going to heat the house with the oven that hot. 500 degrees. A little bit of oregano on top. Simple, easy. I don't have to use the paddle, right? Because I got my screen. I have it on the screen. Look at that. Wait till you taste this when it comes out of the oven. 500 degrees, 9-10 minutes, maybe 8. Bam! Done. Here we go. 10 minutes on the nose, and we're done. 500 degree oven is hot. Be careful. All right, so we have our screen. Easier to handle. Look at that. Look at that. That, I'm telling you, I would put that up against any pizza, anywhere, anytime. So there you have it. You buy some dough, either frozen in the supermarket, or you get it at the local pizza shop and tell them it's for your mother so they don't say, you don't like my pizza? And then you get your pizza cutter, which you can get at Sur La Target for $2, and off you go. Easy to do. And of course, this is the simple, basic kind. If you follow that recipe, I'm sure you'll like it. If you can't get to the boardwalk in Ocean City, and you can put anything on it you want. You want to put artichokes, you want to put goat cheese, you want to put sun-dried tomatoes, you want to put the head of a goat. I don't care. It's up to you. It's your pizza. You make it the way you want. It's easy, it's simple. I hope this helped. Buon appetito!